Hello everyone. In this video, we'll start with a new topic in operations research called linear programming problem. What is linear programming problem? It is basically a mathematical programming technique using which you can optimize the performance. When you say optimize the performance, means achieving the best performance. It can be about maximizing profit or minimizing cost or maximizing sales, minimizing time, minimizing effort, maximizing revenue, like that. So, but that will be whatever you want to optimize, that may be under a set of resource constraints. There may be some sort of restrictions when you try to optimize your performance. And those resource constraints may be related to your man hours or machine hours or money, materials. It can be related to any of the resources, whatever is specified by the organization. That is what is about linear programming problem or linear programming. When we talk about concept of linear programming model, any LPP model, we call it as LPP shortly, any LPP model will contain an objective function, a set of constraints, and non-negativity restrictions. So each of these components means this objective function may contain certain things, set of constraints may contain certain things, and non-negativity restrictions are also may contain certain things. So each of the components may consist of one or more of the following. One is called as decision variables, then objective function coefficients, then technological coefficients, and then availability of resources. So we will understand all these components or the nomenclatures, each one of these nomenclatures. For example, what do we mean by objective function? What do we mean by set of constraints? What do we mean by non-negativity restrictions? Decision variables means what? Objective function coefficients means what? Technological coefficients or technological coefficient matrix, what is that? Availability of resource and then requirement of resources or required resources versus availability. What is all these individual nomenclatures? We'll understand subsequently with an example. In this video, we will discuss only till this. Subsequently, we'll discuss about each of this with an example. In case if you find the contents of this video to be useful to you, I request you to please like it, share it with your friends, and also subscribe to my channel. Thank you.